Hey, what's up guys, I'm here. So it's almost more than 5 months since OnePlus 5 had launched. And this is seriously my best device and most favorite one of 2017. This device was launched with Android Nougat and now this device has started to get Oreo beta updates. OnePlus officially launched the beta version 1 on their website. You can manually flash it, but also there is OnePlus beta version 2 which has been leaked recently. So currently I'm running that, which is slightly better in terms of features. So this video is about those top 10 features and changes in the Android Oreo in this OnePlus 5. So let's get into it. First thing we get this in new version of Android is face unlock. After launching of OnePlus 5T, which is the upgraded variant of the 5, people including me felt very disappointed because the price of both the devices are same. OnePlus 5T launches with the face unlock feature and also this OnePlus 5 gets this feature in open beta version 2, which works same as the OnePlus 5T. Just look at this. After clicking the power button, it unlocks on a blink of eye. Very fast and awesome. It will not work in dark room, but if you increase the brightness of the screen to high, then it will. Second thing is the camera UI. The UI has been redesigned and the settings menu have been moved to the downside. Or if you are using the phone in landscape, then we can say swiping from the right side. All of your options like pro mode, portrait mode, panorama mode, video, slow motion, etc. are present here. It's sometimes difficult to swipe left or right in it as we need to drag from the black area. So number 3, redesigned app section. Now you have many more features and also some of the new features like the parallel apps or spatial access, which I will talk about it later on. But these all are categorized in a single term, which is app. So basically you can see your apps over here, the permissions of apps by this, but for notification you need to go back and select the notification from the settings menu. Fourth thing is the Google autofill. In language and input, there is a new option which saves all your accounts info such as your name, address, saved password, etc. But you might be thinking, how can we use it? As if you are signed in into some app or account, then it will automatically show you autofill so that all the details will be filled automatically and you no need to type it manually. So it will ease the load of work. So the number 5 is the quick toggles design. Now you have some new icon shape and also the number of icons per row has been increased. I think so. You can still edit the quick toggles and also there is a new toggle which is the SIM change. Now you can switch between your SIMs to change the mobile data. No need to go into the settings anymore. Thank you OnePlus for this. But now you cannot see the battery history graph here. You need to go to the battery settings, then you will be able to see it. Why OnePlus? Number 6 is the notification dots. Now you can easily see your apps whether some messages or notifications are pending or not, as there are tiny dots on the right top corner of this app. These dots have same color as the apps and this will remind you that you need to check your apps and reply to your loved ones. Number 7, picture in picture mode. I know it's damn annoying when you want to watch the video but also want to do some other things side by side, or you are listening to music in YouTube video but whenever you minimize the app, the music stops. So this PIP mode will help you in that case. You can simply play the video in the full screen, then just press the home key and the video will still play on the home screen and also in others app too. This will work with the Google Maps so that you can see the navigation and also do your other works too. But issue in this OnePlus 5 is that it works only with few apps. Biggest problem is that it's not working in YouTube. It works on few websites in Chrome. I think this thing might fix in the next update. Number 8, parallel apps. So this thing has been already there from past 2 years. This feature allows you to create two different accounts of the same app by creating a duplicate app of the original one. So you no need to install secondary modded apps from the third party website. You can disable it also whenever you want. I personally use only one app, but I think this thing might be useful for many people around. Number 9 is the smart text selection. So alright, if you're reading an article and there you find a phone number and you want to save it or give a call, then what you will normally do is selecting it and copy, then paste it in dialer app, then dialing the phone number. Or if you find the address, then you want to navigate or find it on maps, then the workload will increase. So to reduce the load, this feature will help you in that. You just need to select the particular thing and then it will automatically decode and then will give you app name right there in the text selection. So it will ease the work to 90%. So directly from here, you can call a number and also you can navigate to your address. Last but not least, which is the number 10, and that is you can directly upload any pic to shot on OnePlus. Also, gallery is redesigned a little. I'm not able to see the back camera pics in collections. only selfie camera pics. But if I want to upload a pic on Short on OnePlus, then I will share it and select Short on OnePlus. So now it is integrated with the sharing and helpful to reduce the workload. So these are all the top 10 new features which you will find after an Oreo update. Some things need to be fixed. Battery life is great. Face unlock is awesome, which I use all the time. And new Android version 2. Totally in love with it. So that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching. I will be appreciate if you consider it liking and sharing the video. And also subscribe for more videos if you already haven't. I will see you guys soon in my next video.